In this video, I want to show you how to make your chemical-free 30+ SPF sunscreen stick. Sun exposure is important for a lot of health benefits, including boosting your vitamin D, which is the building block of the hormone functionality, or also, for example, boosting immunity. However, we know that long exposure to UV rays can also cause skin damage, skin lesions, or even skin cancer. So it's important that we apply sunscreens. However, there are a lot of sunscreens out there that are even more dangerous than the sun itself. The Environmental Working Group has shown that about 2/3 of the sunscreens that we buy at the store are not even blocking the UVA rays. We have UVA rays and UVB rays. UVA rays are more abundant than the UVB rays, and actually the UVA rays are the ones inducing higher risk of skin lesions or even skin cancer compared to the UVB rays. So those sunscreens are not blocking the UVA exposure. And there are also studies showing how those sunscreens are really high in chemicals that are endocrine system disruptors. They go into your bloodstream and they are able to imbalance your hormones, and also they cause a lot of inflammation. Within one day, they can go through the bloodstream and remain in the bloodstream for 3 weeks. So if you decide to buy a sunscreen, these are the ingredients, the chemicals that is a must to avoid: avobenzone, oxybenzone, octocrylin, homosalate, octisalate, and octinoxate. And the second thing to consider when you buy a sunscreen is not just that it's healthy for your body, but it's also healthy for the environment and reef safe. So a really good way to prevent all those chemicals and then protect against the UVA and UVB rays is making your own sunscreen. Of course, homemade sunscreens are not FDA approved because they are not tested in a lab, and it's not very accurate to test exactly which is the SPF that we have in that sunscreen. So try to do your research, and then it's in your hands if you wanna decide to use this sunscreen or not. But I'm gonna show you the sunscreen that I put every time I go to the beach and protect me against all those chemicals and all the UV rays. These are the ingredients that we are gonna use for our sunscreen: 3 tablespoons of melted unrefined coconut oil, 1 heaping tablespoon of beeswax, and 1 tablespoon of non-nano zinc oxide. One of my favorite oils to use when we make a sunscreen is coconut oil. It has to be melted, unrefined virgin or extra virgin cold pressed coconut oil. It's really rich in vitamin E, which is an antioxidant that protects your skin from free radical tissue damage. Also really rich in fatty acids like lauric acid or caprylic acid, which are antimicrobial, but also really good for your skin. Then we're gonna use the beeswax. It's easier to use in the pellet form that you buy it in a block. The beeswax has to be 100% pure and organic. It's a natural antibiotic, it's protecting your skin from inflammation, and also it's protecting your skin from the environment by making a layer that is not clogging the pores of your skin. And we are gonna use beeswax to glue the zinc oxide and the coconut oil and solidify the sunscreen. And the other ingredient is zinc oxide. The metal zinc is oxidized into zinc oxide, which is a mineral that we can find in nature. The good thing about zinc oxide is that it's broad spectrum blocker. It's completely blocking the UV rays, the A, the B, and the C. So it's a really good mineral to add to your sunscreen. The higher the zinc oxide, the more you are gonna protect your body, because we have a higher SPF. So usually a 20% zinc oxide is the equivalent to 30 SPF. We are gonna make a 25%, which is a little bit higher than 30 SPF. The important thing when you buy zinc oxide is that it has to be non-nano. So what does it mean? A nanoparticle is smaller than 100 nanometers, which means if you put a sunscreen with that size of zinc oxide, it's gonna be absorbed through the skin and it's not gonna block the sun. So you want particles that are bigger than 100 nanometers. So it's why you wanna buy zinc oxide that says non-nano zinc oxide. So those particles are bigger. They're gonna stay on the surface of your skin, making a layer that is gonna absorb the UV rays and reflect them. So it's gonna completely block the ultraviolet. So these are different options that we can use to store our sunscreen. We can use an empty container of about 70 milliliters from a previous sunscreen or a deodorant. We can also use a glass container that we line with a BPA-free plastic, so whenever the sunscreen solidifies, we just have to wrap it with the plastic. Or we can use a muffin silicone mold. We can add the sunscreen directly in here, or we can line it with a muffin paper. Or you can buy these cute deodorant containers in an online store. Be sure it's BPA free plastic, and it will fit half of the recipe that we are preparing. We are gonna use a saucepan where we put a little bit of water, and then we are gonna use a glass heat resistance container. In this case, I'm using a measuring cup, and you want to be sure that you are covering with the water at least quarter cup of the container. And we are gonna heat up the water at medium high heat until the water is simmering or boiling. Now that we see that the water is boiling, we are gonna add the coconut oil. Beeswax. And the zinc oxide, we will add it after the coconut oil and the beeswax have melted. We never put the zinc oxide in contact with the fire. I always use some chopsticks because they're disposable, so you can use this or something that you don't really care about or that you can wash well. And then we just keep moving until the coconut oil and the beeswax have completely melted together. As you can see, they are both melted together. Let's turn off the heat. Now carefully that you don't burn yourself, take it out from the fire. And now is the moment to add the zinc oxide. So we are gonna add 1 tablespoon, which is 25% zinc oxide. For this volume, it's gonna make a little bit more of 30 SPF. We add it. And immediately move, 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 until well combined. When it's well combined, not clumpy, everything is dissolved together. Now we can put it immediately in the container where we are gonna let it solidify. So I'm gonna use this container that I had from a previous sunscreen that is about 70 milliliters. Just pour it in. Everything in. And now you're gonna take it to the refrigerator to solidify completely. Within 1 hour, it's gonna be completely solid. And I recommend the refrigerator so it can solidify quickly, so the zinc oxide is not gonna go to the bottom of the container. And this is a sunscreen that you can keep at room temperature. It's not gonna melt into liquid consistency, but if you go to a place where you are gonna have more than 80 Fahrenheit, it may get a little bit softer, so you can keep it in a cooler. So let's refrigerate it. This sunscreen feels very good. Remember to subscribe to my channel if you wanna get more weekly healthy tips, and I hope that now I see you in the next video.